All right, so in this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up a directory using Softr. And Softr is a really interesting piece of software because you can create different apps with it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to be setting up a niche directory. So this is like a smaller niche directory. I think this is a really good opportunity because as search changes with AI, people are still going to want curated information. And this could be a great opportunity in the future. So this is Softr. It's actually built on Softr, and I like that. And it's the number one product of the day on Product Hunt. And so it was made with Softr. So basically what the idea is, you can create no code apps with this empowered by whatever data source that you want. So Airtable, Google Sheets, SQL, databases, even Notion. Okay. So this is really, that's an interesting aspect as well. You can build a database in Notion and use it to power this as well. And you build it with blocks. So no worries, I'm going to show you how to do this. But one thing that I did want to show you is, you know, just about the pricing. And what I like about this is you can actually try it out for free. And you can use these data sources here, Notion, Google Sheets, Airtable. Those are going to be the three ones that are most accessible to non-developers. And you can even publish an app on a custom domain with this, with the free plan. So that's what we're gonna use right now, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'll put a link in the description of this video so that you can go and create an app with Softr. And this is just a brand new account with Softr, so nothing's connected. So I'm just gonna put for fun, okay? And my concept is building a directory. So I'm going to build a directory, but you can build a lot of these different tools with Softr. And the interesting thing is you can even build that database. So you have kind of users log in, authenticate, that sort of thing. So I'm going to put basic what data sources am I going to use. So I'm just going to select those two just to give me the option. And which of these tools are I'm familiar with? I'm familiar with a couple of these. I've used this. Use Bubble a little bit, Zapier, and I've used these. So here you can see when I log in, and because I selected directory, it's going to give me these directories already. And there's different types of directories, like a partner directory. That's not what I'm going to build. A resource directory, no code resources. That's probably the most in line with what I'm going to build. So let's just keep it simple and let's just choose this option. Okay. So basically users can submit resources. There's going to be a contact form. You can search and filter, and it's going to have responsive design. So I'm going to use this template, okay, to do it. And I'm going to say Airtable. So let's use Airtable. So let's connect Airtable. So this is going to ask me to log into my Airtable account, and I'm going to do that and connect with Airtable. All right. So at this point, Softr is requesting access to my Airtable, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to click grant access. The reason I'm going to use Airtable rather than Google Sheets is I just like the interface of Airtable. I like the more Notion-y way of selecting a category rather than using semicolons and things like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create this in Airtable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to authorize this again now that I've got the data in Airtable. And so I'll click to Airtable, and I'm going to add a base. So it says no code base to get full power of this template. And let's click that. So this actually imported a resource library. This is like a template, and you can see what it should look like here. And it's already got this pre-formatted for the template that I'm going to use. So that makes a lot of sense, right? So I could just put my data in here. Here's a long description. Here's the category. And then it's got an image, right? And one of the things that's nice about Softr is, or Airtable, is you can just drag images in. There's a link when it was updated, a long description, and then when it is approved, right? Approved, not approved would be something that would either show or not show on the directory. And I'm just going to refresh here. Okay. So I'm going to select this. This is the one that I'm going to use a template. And here is my Airtable data. I'm going to copy this again, install it in the directories, base. And this is the thing that happens sometimes. Things aren't exactly as smooth as possible. But what we're going to do is just go with it. So it's looking for the base that I've just copied. Try copying again and avoid editing the base. All right, so I haven't edited the base. We'll see if I just close those tabs, if that will solve the problem. All right, so it says here, if you didn't grant to all current and future bases, then we can't see. So I'm gonna need to do that again and re-authenticate the account. All right, so now we've got that synced and we can open that in the application. So let's see. So basically this is all block based here. You can preview it and you can see all these different blocks. So what we're going to do is we're going to start editing this content, and I'll show you, here is the data, right? So this is the live data that we've got, and we can update that, right? So right now it says no code founders. Okay. And you can see the content. So you can adjust this. If you don't want the image, you just hide all the images, right? Just as easy as that. If you don't want the description, you can just remove the description, right? So this is all what you can show. And so this is a short line of text you can add. You can add different fields and all of that. So it's synced. So if you add text here, it will add it to the description as well. So the idea of this really is a directory, okay? So something like that. I can add a background image, all that sort of thing. So what we're going to do here is, this is my Airtable. And so what it's actually done is it's made this base. So this is actually what I'm going to be changing. So I'm just going to copy all my stuff into that one by one, because it's already got the grouping and the formatting. So it'll make it a little bit easier. So for example, here, let's see if we go here, we can see no code founders, right? So no code founders. So I'm going to change this to readable. Okay. And I'm going to copy my description from readable and I'm going to copy it into here. Okay. And then I'm going to change the link. So I'm going to copy the link here and paste it in there. And I'm going to approve that. Now we've got this site here, and let's click preview. So this is my directory here. We can preview to the non-logged in user, all kinds of different things here. And so you see here, it's already dynamically updated readable. Now this makes it very easy to edit your site, because I'm just using this template. I can just change a few names, add a link, and go here. And so it's, when I'm clicking through this, it's going to preview what that dynamic page looks like. And as you see here, now we've got this dynamic page coming in, and we can edit all of this as well. If we go back to the resource directory here, we can see here that this is the long description. And so this can be quite long here, right? And so that's what we can do to build the content on this specific page, right? So it's taking the image there, and we can get another image that we can screenshot the website. And so let's do that now. So I'm just going to go to this site here and take a picture of the screenshot, and it's going to be set for, basically if I use this, then all the images are going to be exactly the same size, and that will look good in the directory. Because when you're dealing with images, if things look a little bit off, if the dimensions are different, then things look a little bit unprofessional, right? So right here, we can see we've got an image here, and we can download this image. Then in our directory, all we need to do here is we're going to delete that image, and then we can just drag the image that we just downloaded right here to that cell. That's all that we've done. Okay. And then let's go back to our site here. Let's go back to our site here, and we'll click refresh. And so now we've got that as the image. Okay. Here, this goes to my link. And so this is a completely dynamic page that we built from this. Obviously, there's other things we want to adjust on this directory. We want to adjust, let's say, the header and change the image of what these are, the contact us, add resource, all that sort of stuff. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this image. Okay. And I'm going to add my image and I'm going to upload an asset and I'm going to search for, I think this one should be good. Okay. I've already uploaded that. So that's in my asset section. So this is just something I designed in Canva, just very simple. And we've got that set up. So link text, soccer tools, and you can choose to open it in a tab. And this will go to CTA 5, okay, which will be down on the page a little bit. So we've got this. We can change the color of these buttons and everything like that. This is always good to have on your directory. I'll just put soccer training advancements. Just put something fun. Be the first on your block to get the newest innovative soccer gear. And we can obviously update the image. We don't want to do that, but I'm not going to do that in this video because editing images, sometimes it looks good and sometimes it looks bad, and we'll just leave it at that. Okay. What we want to do is if someone wants to add a resource here, we want them to be able to add a resource. Okay. And we can open the page, add a resource. Okay. So that's going to be on the pages here. We can see the different pages here. So we have this add a resource page. And so this is already built in the image or in the thing. And you can change the different blocks that you may want for this form, right? So put an image here. What do people want to know? So add a about new tools. So fill out this form. Product. Okay. So that's good. So we'll actually put it in this Airtable, right? And it's going to be not approved so that we can actually be able to approve it, right? And so that's going to be pretty interesting as well. So this is just a very simple page here. We also can change the whole theme, right? So if we want to change it, we can change all this stuff. And again, that's not something that I'm really going to make you watch me go through and do it. You can add different users. And of course, then you're going to have your settings here, right? And you do want to customize some of this so that it will be more related to general SEO. You'll see that you have some of these things that are just in trial where you can add like custom code and things like that, app history. Yeah, this is something you can upload a favicon, all that sort of thing. Okay. And apart from that, what you want to do is you want to publish this, right? So what I'm actually going to do is custom subdomain. So I did it on, just publish on a softer subdomain or on your custom domain. And so we can add a custom domain here. Namecheap, that's who I use for my domains. I'm logged in here and here's a domain that I registered for this. And so what we're going to do is go through and that. Okay. So I'm just going to do soccertraininghub.com. Okay. And paste it in here. And I'm going to add that domain. So we've got to publish this first. So publish it. Let's just give it a name there. And so I'm going to publish it. Okay. And now it's published. And I'm going to add a custom domain, Soccer Training Hub. Let's preview the site, right? .preview.softr.app. So now I've got this all set up. And as you can see here, this is my content that I created. And I just need to go through and add that to some of the other ones that I've added. And then I can build this whole directory out. What's great about it is that people are going to be able to respond back to it. And so the easiest way to do this would be to delete all of these. Okay, the ones. So for example, the next one is going to be Blaze Pod here. And so I'll just put it here, Blaze Pod. I'm going to replace the link. I'm going to get a new screenshot. I need to copy the short text here over, or the shorter text. So with this, here's the description. And so I'm going to really change this to just short description, okay, even though it's a long text field. And then the long description, as you can see, you can write quite a bit of content and use emojis and things like that in it. So I'm going to unapprove these ones because these are going to be changed. Okay. And we'll go back, see if we got this screenshot. And we do, but it's got this sale on it. So I probably want to just go over and take a screenshot of that normally. Okay, so we'll accept the cookies and take a screenshot. So we've got this here. Just gonna take a screenshot like that, and that should be pretty good for our purposes. All right, so I'm gonna go File, Save As. But I'll just put this in as an example so you can see how to do that one more time. Okay. So again, this is a live directory. Now I can change this new soccer hub. Okay. And I can change this. So I'm going to delete this. And I'm going to take the new Blaze Pod and drop it in here. Okay. And what's great about this is you can see this change happening in essentially in real time. So here is our site preview as a non-logged in user. We can see the directory here. We see we've got only got two approved right now because we unapproved these other ones. And that's really how easy it is. You just go through and adjust them. And then once they're, you know, once you approve the long description and the image and all that, then you can approve them and they will show up in real time. And so let's go look at this other page just so we can preview it as well. You can see here, they've got the image that we selected and the link to my website. There's lots of opportunity with this. And if you are interested in this, I'll put a link to Softr and to Airtable in the description below. And if you use the Airtable link, you should get a credit. So that should be very helpful for you when you're building this out. So let me know if you have any questions about niche directories. This is something that I'm passionate about. And I think that if you have knowledge in a specific area that you can build a directory around, it sure could make a lot of sense. And you can change how this is filtered as well with these different categories. And these are just showing up because they're in the database, but you can change these. So it will show up in the categories only that I've done. If someone clicks on that, it will only show up for that. Hopefully this video was helpful. And let me know in the comments, what kind of directory you plan on creating? And I'll see what I can do to help. All right. Take care. We'll see you in the next video.